time, so but probably I need to do this. How many are you from engineering background as such? Okay, good. Even I am from engineering background, and you know, before I go, let me introduce myself. My name is Mukund Surange, and I have over 25 years of industry experience. I have background of computer science from IIT Bombay, and also MBA from IIM Bangalore many years back. So I spent more than 8 years in leading startups. Okay, and saw some failures as well. Okay, and before that I was in IBM for over 18 years. So I have a lot of experience on the big corporates as well as startups. Okay, so coming back on the startups, and today I want to talk a little bit on marketing. And the reason why I asked, you know, how many of you are from engineering background, typically, and I go through lot of pitches and lot of presentations. One of the common thread which I have seen, especially from people who are from engineering background, there is a feeling that you built a good product and people will be jumping to buy it. Okay, I mean, that nothing could be far from truth. Okay, so with that as caveat, you know, I want to spend this 4-5 minutes, and probably that's the only time I have. So while 5 minutes is too less a time, but I'll just give you a quick flavor of, you know, what marketing pitfalls you should avoid. And how much, just quick another show of hands. How many of your exposure or experience in marketing or sales you have? Okay, so a lot of, most of them you don't have it, so it's good. And my pitch will, or my presentation will make much more sense there. So one example which I can think of immediately is between, you know, Mac and Microsoft, Mac and Windows, right? And Mac is much superior product than Windows. I hope everyone agrees to that, right? I myself don't use, you know, Mac. I use Windows, but Windows has done far better in the market. Therefore, marketing would be one reason. There are a lot of other reasons, but just for example, your Coke versus fruit juice, you know, so there are tons of examples like that. So don't underestimate the need of marketing. Okay, marketing is very much needed for success. So, that said, understand, you need a good product to sell. Marketing is not a substitute for a bad product. If you have a bad product, it's not going to sell. It may sell, if you do a very successful marketing, it may sell for some time. But a poor product is not going to go for a long time. So what I will spend, if I just have 3-4 slides, given that my time is limited, just to give a flavor of what especially people, entrepreneurs, may want to avoid, you know. One, don't try to please all your customers. You know, it's easy to say, difficult to do. As an entrepreneur, I have been guilty of that myself. In one of my previous companies, we tried to look at all the segments, and it is natural. You may want to think, if this doesn't, if I can't sell to person A, I want to sell to person B or person C. So I want to try to please everyone. It doesn't work. I mean, you become jack of all trades and, you know, master of none. So you want to be very careful. This is more than a marketing segment, actually. It's more of a strategy side, but very key, very important for marketing as well. Okay, whatever limited amount of money you have, the marketing needs up to 20%. Most for startups, 20%, you know, most of the marketing budget 20%. For large internet companies, 40-50% is reserved for sales and marketing. So it's a lot of budget you want to spend properly. Of all the things, if you want to remember one thing of what I am saying, is this. Right early in your cycle or your time, understand the difference between B2C and B2B. This one alone will save you a lot of problems. The sales cycle is different, the marketing funnels are different, the way you approach people are different, the skills are different, you know. So that's one thing we want to remember. You know, a couple of years back, and I'm sure it's coming to everyone, right? All of us used to get calls, I used to get one every day, every other day. Do you want a free credit card? I don't know, all of you must be getting it, right? But frankly, I don't get those nowadays, but nowadays I get calls on, do you want a life insurance, do you want a medical insurance? Just remember, just think, just imagine if those are the salespeople who want to sell the life insurance, medical insurance to corporates, they are not capable. So you need very different kind of skills, very different kind of budget. So this one and one line, if you want to remember from this presentation, this is it. So other important point is, don't ignore the website. People don't normally ignore in the sense, most of the people I have seen, most of the companies I have seen, they have a website. They have a rudimentary website. But what is important is, you need to have a website which is updated continuously with the right information. Most of the entrepreneurs which I have seen, you know, they are from technical background, a lot of them, and being in Bangalore, most of them are from technical background, they create one website. But that's it, you know, after that the product changes, but website doesn't change. So that's extremely important. Website needs to be updated regularly with the right information, with the right stuff that you want to convey to stakeholders, could be for investors, could be for customers. So it's very important stuff. Other thing is, you know, look at whether outsourcing makes sense for some activities, not for the strategy.
That's the 4th minute of
5 minutes
is up.
Okay.
So you have 2 more minutes.
Okay. Sounds good. So just look at whether you want to outsource some of the activities, because marketing will need a lot of different skills. You know, you may not, you need graphics person, you need people who can do ad copy, who can run Facebook or online. So you can't, if you try to hire all of them, it would be very expensive for startup. Look at people who can, look at whether it makes worth, it makes sense in outsourcing. And, you know, don't be inflexible, you know, and probably I don't need to overemphasize that. You need to look at what's working. You have a lot of assumptions, you keep on, you need to validate it. Something may work, it may not work opposite. You may think something is working, or something might work based on hunches, you will realize that it may not work. Okay, and there are many more, you know, but finally, all I would summarize is, use professional judgment and use the money wisely. Okay. Don't overspend it. Don't spend very early in the cycle. Use your money for, use your marketing budget judiciously. Okay. So this is, I hope I did it in 7 minutes. I wanted to keep, small what I was asked by the organizers. But if you have any questions, feel free to, I don't know. Now or later or today.
Anything you want to ask, because we still have one more buzzer, it's not gone off. So, what's the difference between B2B guy and B2C guy that you're talking of?
The, in the sense,
resource
people. So let's, I mean, you understand B2B versus B2C difference, right? So take the example, you know, what is, say you're getting calls for credit card, right? What you're saying. Those are the people who are trying to sell to individual consumers, right? They have a credit card. Those are not the people who can sell to corporate consumers, right? The entire decision-making cycle is very different. Now, you need a person who can understand, who can talk to corporate procurement department, or, you know, whoever are the, who are the corporate buyers. They are very sophisticated people. The corporate buying cycle is extremely different from individual way. Look at, if I want to buy a mobile, you know, would be very different from how corporate want to buy mobiles for their sales people, just for example. It's a very different cycle. You know, I may just look at 3-4 mobiles of different companies and, you know, look at what are my requirements. Maybe I want a very good camera. So I may make a decision within 3-4 days, maybe compare a few mobiles within my budget, look at what features are. That's very different from, if a corporate wants to give mobiles to salespeople, they might be buying in bulk, right? So the entire life cycle or the entire sales cycle, buying cycle, extremely different. So they would look for, they'll call tenders, then there'll be negotiations, there'll be requirements. So if you want to sell to a sophisticated buyer, the seller also has to be sophisticated. You can't have the same skills. And the people who are selling credit card to me, they will not be able to sell credit card to a corporate buyer, just frozen buyer. Need a very different kind of skills. Does that answer the question?
What is that differentiator, skill
differentiator? For a credit card seller, it could be any person they graduate with, they'll understand English, train for a week on the product, that's it. For a corporate person, what will you better have a MBA in sales, or a person who has who understands sales properly, okay? That is the kind of sophisticated stuff. Was that the question?
Yeah. Okay. Or anyway, further you could have it during the networking.
Sure. Thank you.